When I was 8, I had a recurring dream for over a month. Once I was so afraid to sleep that I was awake for 3 days. In my dream, me and my sisters are drinking cola in our basement. Suddenly my sisters' faces start to get weird. Their mouths and noses get really small. Only their eyes are there above their neck. I start to run upstairs but a creature grabs my neck and pulls me up. The face was like a normal one but it had another skin above it. It started to scream like a demon and I just can't do anything else but screaming back. My mother said in the first night I screamed 3 hours before I woke up. After this, I was heck scared of the basement for a long time. I know almost every one of you have experienced something creepy in your basement. You can share your experience with us. My very first nightmare I can remember was when I was 5. I had a friend named Gracie, and in my dream we were at her house drawing with chalk on her deck. She lived on a cliff and beneath it instead of water it was kind of like the Badlands in Lion King, just thickets of thorns stretched out as far as I could see. Well, Gracie's mom came out and started yelling at us for drawing on the deck. But the weird thing was this lady wasn't Gracie's mom, she was something evil and I could tell. It was like she was transforming into something dark and ugly in front of my eyes but Gracie couldn't see it. She finds out that I know she is evil and throws both of us off the cliff. I hit the bottom and open my eyes and see Gracie with thorns sticking to her. Then the dream just ends. On second grade, I go to school one day and Gracie isn't there. My teacher says the class that she had drowned while riding her tricycle beside the pool at her house. Gracie's parents fill in the pool, file for divorce and move. After 8 years, our church builds a walk trail through her backyard. My brother is 7 and I'm 14. We are walking and out of nowhere he points to her house and says, Gracie says hello. I said, what are you talking about, Cam? And he says, the wet girl. I have never told him about Gracie. The worst dream I have ever had was that I was walking through the parking lot of Kmart to my car. Before I could understand the situation, a stranger grabbed my infant daughter and took off with her. I ran after the kidnapper but before I could grab my daughter the stinger fell into a manhole and was washed away. It was so frightening and upsetting that I actually woke myself up shrieking and crying. I actually took the entire day off from office and did my best to go back to sleep and try to turn that dream around in my favor, because I just couldn't cope with it ending with her still being gone. Took me weeks to get over it. I once had a nightmare where I was swimming in our pool with my family. I dunk my head underwater and then swam to the pool bed. Suddenly the water became dark, so I lift my head up out of the water. It is already night. What I saw then scared the hell out of me. I say my family gone and all the people are nowhere to be found. There is not even an animal or vehicle. Everything is silent. I am the only person on the whole town. I look up to the sky. There is a giant eyeball looking at me. A huge hand comes, grabs the pool and folds it into a clear box. I got trapped in the water-filled box and I am running out of breath. I wake up gasping for breath. Scariest dream I've had in a while. Last week I start dreaming that I am in an apartment. Everything seems real, and there are a few cats moving about like cats do. Suddenly though, one of the cats jump off the balcony and made me start realizing that something is off. I walk to the kitchen of this apartment and sit down. Suddenly a cat jump onto the chair next to mine and I turn away, because looking at it feels like looking at the sun, however it is not bright. Then this cat starts slowly morphing into a different creature, with a messed up disturbing face. I watch through the corner of my eye while another cat jumps onto the table. It is crying out blood instead of tears. It have its upper jaw but not its lower. Tentacles are coming blasting of its belly. I am so scared and disgusted that I feel like throwing up. I jumped out of the chair to find out that it was only a dream lying on my bed. But I still threw up even after waking up. Another dream in which I am lying on a bed in a wrecked house. But I can't move my body. I shout but my throat is so dry that no sound will come out. I feel something at my right but I can't move my head. So I try to see through the corner of my eye. A cat is sighting to my right looking at me. It have a disgusting face and is bathed with blood. I hear a bang outside the window so I look the other way, away from the cats. When I look back, The scary-looking cat is gone and in its place is a humanoid creature. I can see its body, but its face is clear, squarish, pale. Completely featureless except for two completely black eyes. I was so scared but I can't scream. Suddenly it feels like the entire world is moving towards me even though I am still. The creature is still in my room staring right into my eyes and I can't move, it's getting closer. I decide to somehow push myself off my bed so that I can awaken from the nightmare. I slowly twitch my way to the edge of the bed while this thing is coming towards me at a steady pace, then I fall off the edge and black out. Did you guys ever think cats can scare you so much? Couldn't sleep well for days scared that it would return and got scared whenever I saw a cat. Worst one that I remember is when I was doped up on dilaudid at Loma Linda. I was in a glass box in the middle of a mall. The box is closed on all sides except the top. I had rivets parched all over my skin, and blood pouring out of them. The box was filling up, and I was going to drown in my own blood. I was crying for help and the only thing people did, was stop, giggle and wave, and carry on. No one came near me. No one was there to help me. I was scared. I shouted, "Why isn't anyone helping me? I am dying." Then things got worse. A 3-foot dwarf man came to me. His face and hands are covered with blood. His nose is sharp and nails are long. A creepy, disgusting caterpillar-like creature came out of his nose. He pulled the creature out and put it on my head. As it touched my skin, little other caterpillars blessed foot of it crawling towards my ear. Those slimy, dirty creatures entered my ear, nose and filled my mouth. As my nose is blocked and my mouth is full, I couldn't breathe. My heart beat so fast that I woke up from the dream with severe pain in my chest. A short dream, but scary nonetheless. I believe it was my birthday and I had some sort of huge party organized outside in my garden. So I was running around the garden for some reason when I felt like grabbing some birthday cake. I ran into the kitchen and my dad was eating my cake, so I asked him for some. But for some reason my dad pushed me to the floor and told me all the cake was for him. My mom confronted my dad, but before she could really start shouting, he proceeded to grab a rather large kitchen knife and stab my mom right between the eyes, with the knife going all the way through her head. Even though it was a dream, I remember the blood splatter quite vividly. I then woke up in a cold sweat and was freaked out for weeks. I had sleep paralysis about a month ago. I awoke from deep sleep early in the morning to an unfamiliar voice, deep and distorted. I heard more voices, and tried to move but couldn't. I saw a bunch of men approaching me, who had no faces but plenty of razor-sharp teeth. They were grinding their teeth and whispering "food, food, food, food," coming closer and closer, to the point where I could see what they were holding: knives and forks. They gathered around me and then climbed on top of me and slowly carved me up like a turkey. They ripped my arms and legs off and ate them. They went head first into the rest of my body and tore me apart like ravenous dogs. I then watched them use my finger bones as toothpicks. Finally, I broke free of the paralysis and went on to listen to Beethoven for three hours to get rid of the thought of being eaten alive. I hope nothing like that happens to you guys. My dream was of my family and me sitting together in an empty field. There was a lot of dirt. I turned and looked at a mountain in the distance. It basically evaporated in a wall of fire. I got scared and thought to flee, but my daughters and my husband didn't. So I pulled them, but they won't come. Instead, they caught my tight and I couldn't move. The hot lava is approaching towards us and the mountain have turned into a lake of lava. I tried hard to at least save my daughters. I pulled them, tried to convince them, shouted at them, but they were acting as if nothing happened. I look back to see the mountain. We are surrounded by the lava. I felt the fear of death, so I hold tight my daughters. The heat burned me along with my family. Unable to tolerate the pain, I shouted as loud as I could. My husband woke me out of the nightmare. He said that I was screaming while in sleep. He woke up hearing me scream. Even my daughters came to comfort me. He asked me why was I so scared. Because I have never screamed in sleep. When I told them my nightmare, all my family members hugged and promised to never to give me cold feet. I distinctly remember the burning I felt on my back as I woke up. The end of the world nightmares scare me the most since my family has a history of prophetic dreams. where many family members, me included, have had dreams of things sometimes years before they had.
In my dream, I was driving my car and was in a hurry for something important to me, but I don't know what. But on the way I saw my other car, and in it my wife was dying. I don't know why or how, but she was in my car parked in the street somewhere in the next neighborhood and was dead/dying. I didn't do it, I didn't kill her, but people were going to think it was my fault because she was in my car. So I left her there in the car after I found her there because she was starting to decompose but also somehow was still barely alive. When she looked at me, it was almost zombie-like. And everything was dark. Even my headlight of a different car were too dull to see well. And the rot from her decaying body was following me around, slowly creeping onto everything I saw. I started bleeding out of my nose as I ran home. Most of the house was dark and the rot was there. Black gunk and maggots and decay. I had just a small bag, a pillow, and that dull flashlight running out of batteries. I wanted to sleep so I could ignore all of this crazy, scary stuff and forget about the rot until the sun came up and gave me the safety of the daylight. I went to the couch in my clean room to try to sleep, but I had a feeling the rot would find me there anyway and creep in. I turned off the dying flashlight and closed my eyes. Then I woke up.